Hi there, it's Meonicorn. We are already 4 days into February, so it means it's time to wrap up all the books that I read in the first month of 2018. In January, it's a very interesting reading month for me because I have read 8 plus 1 books. I said plus 1 books because one of the books I read is part of a bind-up book, and also 5 of the books that I read is part of the same series. And in the 9 books, I read 1 poetry collection, 3 non-fiction books, and also 5 fiction books. Let's start with the poetry collection. The poetry collection I read is Teaching My Mother How to Give Birth by Washen Shenri. I really enjoyed the reading experience of this book. Although it's really small, but you got all kinds of emotions from it. I would say the keywords of this poetry collection is war, love, feminism, and immigration. It combines with the author's expression with grief, uncertainty, sorrow, and powerless, but you also got strong uphold and pride. The last poem of this poetry collection is very popular. It's called In Love and In War. It has only 2 sentences. It says, "To my daughter, I will say, when the men come, set yourself on fire." But I really love another quote from the longest poem in this collection. The poem is called Conversations About Home. All I can say is, I was once like you, the empathy, the pity, the ungrateful placement. And now, my home is the mouth of a shark. Now my home is the barrel of a gun. I will see you in the other side. I think it's very powerful and I cannot get it out of my mind. And initially, I gave this poetry collection 4 stars out of 5 because I think they are all good, but I don't have the one that shocked me and impressed me a lot to make me love it. But thinking about it now, I will raise the star rating to 5 stars because I really love the poem. The second book I read is A Room of One's Own by Virginia Woolf. It is my plus one book because this is a bind up with A Room of One's Own and The Three Gannets. And I have only read the first part, A Room of One's Own. And I have to say, this is more difficult than other books that I read. And sometimes I have to reread some sentences or paragraphs. And if I left like a chapter in the middle of the chapter, and I have to reread the whole chapter when I return to the book. But with that being said, I think I also gained a lot from this book. I think we are all familiar with the quote from this book. It's, "A woman must have money and a room of her own if she is to write fiction." And throughout the book, Virginia Woolf listed a lot of facts and also imaginary examples to support her ideas. And besides the fact that the reading is slightly difficult than other books, I do enjoy the reading experience a lot, and I'm more than happy to continue reading Virginia Woolf. And also, I think I'm going to, because I have taken some annotations from the book. And the next step, I think I will just write all my annotations down on my notebook and for my own thoughts. And the next nonfiction I have read is Why I'm No Longer Talking to White People About Race by Eddo-Lodge. I think it's an excellent book and everybody should read it. And it's actually informative for me, maybe because I'm not that familiar with the race issues in UK. And also the book is not only about race, it's also about gender, class, and power and all of that. And I especially enjoy when Eddo-Lodge sharing her experience about why she turned from mainly discuss about issues about feminism to mainly discuss the issue about racial. And this book made me realize that all the problem with racial, with gender and also class and so on are actually the same problem. It's a privilege with like whatever the stronger group has. And I also love her opinion about the express of anger, because I once held the opinion is anger was like unnecessary and unhelpful. The most important thing for us is to stay in peace and also try to understand why other people holding the different opinion of yours, and even when they are hurting you. Now I'm still believing that because understanding each other is the most important things in the world, I think. But also, I have changed a little bit because this book makes me think maybe sometimes the rational express of anger actually do help the situation, and people can get together because of it and maybe make some changes. And also I want to say, although all the books that I read this month is last month, it's slightly different, but they kind of have the same thing, so I'm really happy about it. So next, the other nonfiction that I read kind of cross over with my reading theme of January is Shrill by Lindy West. This is the author's memoir and I have listened to it via audiobook, where Lindy West narrated by herself. It is very pleasant when you're listening to celebrity memoirs which are narrated by themselves, and this book is no exception. Lindy West is a writer and a comedian. This book is all about her experience of being a loud feminist and also a celebrity who is judged by other people, especially strangers. She has some in-depth thought of comedy industry, and I really like her opinion of the inappropriate jokes around females in comedy industry. I'm not very familiar with the comedy industry, but based on this book, Lindy West said there are some jokes around female, around sexuality, and also around maybe some issues like rape. And that will lead to the fact that maybe it will discourage some people to stand up and protect themselves. And with that topic, I'm 100% agree with Lindy West's opinion. And the other Lindy West story impressed me is when she was made an internet troll, and the troll created a fake Twitter account using her father's name to troll her on the internet, especially after her father just passed away. And she wrote about her frustrations about that internet troll on her blog. And in the end, the internet troll actually apologized to Lindy West through email. And turned out that he was angry with Lindy West for no reason, and actually he was angry with himself at that time. So the story really made me think that sometimes the trolls are maybe decent person in life, but they just, because some events in their lives, they just choose to express their emotions by trolling other people. And in the end, Lindy West actually interviewed the troll for some of her project. So I think it's a very impressive story. And the 5 fiction books I read are the 9th book to the 13th book of a series of unfortunate events. And I will put all the covers here. And I won't say a lot about the story, but a series of unfortunate events is a story about 3 Bonalia children one day lost their parents in a big fire, and they started their adventure, aka unfortunate event. And I had read the first 8 books last year and stopped because the story kind of get redundant. But from the 9th book on, the story actually getting more and more interesting because the children are more and more near the truth about their own unfortunate event. And also they started to develop some relationship out of the 3 of them. And I think the end is perfect for this series. And overall, I think it's a very relaxing and interesting story to read. And that's all the 9 books that I read in January. I'm very, very happy about it. And I'm very much looking forward to the books that I plan to read in February. Did you read any book you like in January? Do you have any recommendations? Let's chat in the comment section down below. And until next time, happy reading. Bye.